We followed the suspect's movements through the woods out to an access road about a mile away.
Yeah, it wasn't easy either. Suspect knew how to cover his tracks. He used switchbacks to throw off his scent.
Fits the profile of someone with tactical training.
Yeah, well, he didn't cover everything. We found tire tread marks on the access road.
He had a getaway car. We need to find it.
Already have. I got several traffic cam photos of the vehicle headed back towards New Orleans.
Oh, why does his face look like that?
Oh, he's probably wearing some kind of an infrared cap. Blocks your image from being recorded.
Where's the car now?
NOPD found it 10 minutes ago, dumped and tossed outside of town.
All right, I'll tell Harper.
Well, let's check it first. Then we'll call FBI. I don't want to waste Harper's time if it's nothing.
Is that a good idea?
No, it's not. FBI should be informed immediately. It's still a joint operation.
Aren't you supposed to be on vacation?
I was called back. The bosses are a bit concerned about the chemical weapons floating around out there.
We got it under control.
DZ wants a little hand-holding. Follow up on that car, see if you can pull any evidence. Can we talk?
Alone?
I'm really sorry they called you back, Duane. I know you're supposed to be in New York tomorrow with Laurel.
We got bigger problems. Deputy Director Van Cleef tells me you defied FBI orders during the raid.
That is not how I would portray it. I was trying to save lives.
FBI didn't see it that way. They're furious. It's gone up the chain.
Okay. Okay. Who do I apologize to?
Bigger than that, Hannah. Official Washington's involved now. Two FBI agents wounded and a bomb missing.
I get it, Duane, and I'm on it. I'm going to go out there, I'm going to get that bomb, and I'm going to bring it home. It's what we do.
Not you. You're being held back pending an immediate review of your actions. You're suspended.